Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy, the best social justice warrior on the internet, and today we're gonna be talking about
100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist.
What?
100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist. 100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist. 100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist. Deros, 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 deros.
But Charles, I hear none of you say, because each and every one of you who watches my channel is obviously a level 12 intellect, someone who surpasses even Elon Musk in brain power. What is a stereotype? So if you search on Google, a stereotype is a widely held but fixed and oversimplified image or idea of a particular type of person or thing. And is there anything more to it than that? Nah, not really. That's basically what it is. And what we're going to be talking about today is a very specific kind of thing caused by stereotypes called
Mr. Simon, bring me a dream.
Bum, 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 bum.
Make him the cutest that I've ever seen.
So if you check on the best source of unbiased and true information on the internet, otherwise known as Wikipedia, you'll find that stereotype threat can cause people who are labeled with a stereotype to be worse at certain things due to a mental effect that it has on them. So, for example, this could be black people doing worse in a courtroom environment because black people are commonly labeled as more likely to be criminals. This could be white people being less likely to do well on academics and such because people think that white people are redneck losers. This might be Italian people being stereotyped as liking spaghetti and stuff. I don't know why this would be a stereotype. And this could be Asian people, you know, being labeled as kung fu masters. But that these stereotypes aren't really the ones that are most likely to influence you during your everyday life. Those stereotypes would be more like Asians being labeled as people who are excellent at math, or black people being labeled as extremely good athletes. So these stereotypes can even extend to things that are not race related, like for example the stereotype that Linux users are all stuck up assholes who really can't fathom using any other operating system because they just think that Linux is the best one. So it's very nice and all to talk about all these stereotypes, but I think the most important part of this would be talking about how to deal with stereotype threats. So let's talk about that now.
We used to be best friends and things were cool, but then you went and touched it, made me look like a fool. It was my.
So the following content that I have in this video is it's entirely based on my opinions. So if you don't like that kind of stuff, if you only like to stick to the facts, please stop watching this video. But before you do that, please like the video and subscribe to my channel because I have no life other than YouTube. Please just validate my existence, okay? So the big problem about the stereotype threat and about social justice in general is that websites like BuzzFeed and like MTV like to pick on some terms and circle jerk them way out of proportion so that they get really angry whenever the term is said. But that just increases how much the stereotype is seen as important in everyday eyes. If you can't mention it, then it's going to be very important to everyone. That's not the way to deal with it. For example, if someone gets triggered over saying the word, the actual physical word gay, which is a normal word, then in the future, no one's gonna say gay, so then when someone actually does, it's gonna be way worse. The only way to actually deal with stereotype threat as a whole is to just make people's skins harder and make it so that they don't get offended when these stereotypes or when these words are said. That's the only way that we can actually deal with these things. And stuff like going after innocent people for making microaggressions, for making tiny references to stereotypes that might be or might not be there, that has to stop. And like, yeah, that's just not a good way to deal with this whole deal. So, Please like and subscribe, guys.
Hey, old Breezy. Let me show you how to keep the dice rolling when you're doing that thing over there. Hey.
Let's go!
Cause I'm feeling like I'm running and I'm feeling like I gotta get away.